Let's now look into the request message definition. In the request, we have two parameters. The ECU reset request SID, which is mapped to value 11, and then the subfunction, which is mapped to reset types. Let's now have a deeper look into different reset type values. In the last video, we had a look into first diagnostic service, diagnostic session control service. Let's now get into details of our next diagnostic service, that's ECU reset service, service 11. The ECU reset service is used by client to request a server reset or restart. Based on the reset type embedded in the ECU reset request, server shall perform the reset accordingly. Server shall send a positive response before performing the reset operation. Server shall not accept or respond to any request sent during the time following the positive response message to the ECU reset request until the reset operation is completed. Let's now look into the request message definition. In the request, we have two parameters. The ECU reset request SID, which is mapped to value 11, and then the subfunction, which is mapped to reset types. Let's now have a deeper look into different reset type values. Firstly, we have value 0. This value is reserved by the ISO 14229 standard. Next, we have value 1, which maps to hard reset. This value identifies a hard reset condition which simulates the power on startup sequence typically performed after a server has been previously disconnected from its power supply or after a reprogramming of the ECU. This operation shall lead to reinitialization of volatile memory location. Non-volatile memory location initialization is implementation specific. Next, we have value 2, which maps to key off on reset. This value identifies a condition similar to the driver turning the ignition key off and back on. This reset condition should simulate a key off on sequence. Typically, this operation shall lead to reinitialization of volatile memory location, whereas the non-volatile memory locations are preserved. Next, we have value 3, which maps to soft reset. This value shall cause the server to immediately restart the application program. Typically, this operation shall restart the application without reinitializing previously learned configuration data and also other long-term adjustments, preserving the non-volatile and sometimes also the volatile memory. Next, we have value 4, which maps to enable rapid power shutdown. This value is only applicable to battery-powered ECUs. The value shall force sleep mode on the ECU rather than power off. The intention of the subfunction is to reduce the stand-up time of the ECU after ignition is turned off. The server shall transition to rapid power shutdown mode either immediately or after a defined stand-up time to sleep mode once key ignition is switched off. Then we have value 5, which maps to disable rapid power shutdown. This value shall request server to disable the previously enabled rapid power shutdown function. Then we have a range of value from value 6 to 3F and also 7F. These values are reserved by the ISO 14229 standard. Then we have the value range from 40 to 5F. These values are reserved for vehicle manufacturer. And then 60 to 7E. These values are reserved for system suppliers. The response of the ECU reset can either be positive or negative. Let's first have a look into the positive response. Firstly, we have the ECU Reset Response SID, which maps to value 51. Then we have the subfunction in the response, which is equal to the subfunction present in the request. Then we have the power down time, which indicates the minimum time of the standby sequence when the server remains in the power down sequence. This parameter is only supported if subfunction is set to enable rapid power shutdown. The resolution of the parameter is 1 second. The range of value that's supported is from 0 to FE, which is from 0 to 254 seconds, and FF, which indicates failure or time not available. Let's now look into the negative response. Some of the typical negative response obtained for ECU reset are NRC12, that subfunction not supported. This NRC shall be sent if the subfunction parameter is not supported. Then we have NRC13, incorrect message length or invalid format. This NRC shall be sent if the length of the message is wrong. Then we have NRC22, which is condition not correct. This NRC shall be sent if the criteria for ECU reset request are not met. And lastly, we have NRC33, which is security access denied. This NRC shall be sent if the requested reset is secure and the server is not in an unlocked state. Let's look at an example where the client is sending a hard reset to the server through the diagnostics. The message exchange shall be as stated. With this, we had a detailed look into the ECU reset service in this session. In upcoming session, we will have a look into the Secure Access 27 service. Thank you.